So it's been said that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach. Well, I'd actually like to expand on that and add a woman's heart, too. But in this season of love, maybe it's not just all about romance, because there are lots of ways to spread the love through food. Here are some awesome restaurants, cafes, and projects who all celebrate Food for a Cause. This looks delicious.
There's Women's Bean Project, The Squeaky Bean, Denver Cat Company, Same Cafe, Vesta Dipping Grill, Denver Urban Gardens, and Project Angel Heart's Dining Out for Life.
Rachel West here to guide you through some fun and scrumptious ways to share the love. Let's get going.
In addition to being a great and unique place to eat, Vesta Dipping Grill has a very big heart. This awesome restaurant, opened in the emerging Lodo district of downtown Denver in 1997, has worked with Urban Peak for over 19 years to help youth overcome adverse situations. Urban Peak is the only nonprofit organization in Denver that provides full services for youth ages 15 to 24 experiencing homelessness or at risk of becoming homeless. Vesta has helped raise over $250,000 for Urban Peak since the organization began. One of the big fundraisers is Plates for the Peak. The event is held right at the Vesta Dipping Grill. It has a fun cocktail party atmosphere while serving 11 rounds of creative dishes from the chefs from Vesta, plus Steubens and Ace Eat Serve. Hope you're hungry. So you can help support youth by supporting Vesta Dipping Grill. Quite a tasty way to help. So, the name Vesta was derived from the Roman goddess of food, drink, or the hearth. The answer, meant to conjure feelings of warmth and family gatherings, it was derived from the Roman goddess of the hearth. Seeds! Lots and lots of seeds! The Free Seeds and Transplants program from Denver Urban Gardens allows low-income individuals to plant organic fruits and vegetables to feed their families. Last year, almost 30,000 seed packets were distributed. The program was initiated by the City of Denver, and in 1997, Denver Urban Gardens was asked to take over the project. These seeds will turn into fresh, healthy food for many families this year. Denver Urban Gardens' mission is to grow community, one urban garden at a time. The organization was established in 1985 in order to support Denver residents in creating sustainable, food-producing neighborhood gardens. They operate these gardens throughout the metro area, including more than 40 that are school-based. For over a decade, Denver Urban Gardens has worked in partnership with Denver Public Schools and other groups to provide educational programs for youth. In 2015, in addition to the seed packets, Denver Urban Gardens distributed over 76,000 plants, and they served over 58,000 people through household and group applications. Pretty awesome. Okay, how many community gardens does Denver Urban Gardens operate? More than 50, 75, or 150? The answer, Denver Urban Gardens operates more than 150 community gardens.
How about sharing the love with the animals too? No worries, we've got you covered. We're here at the Denver Cat Company, a cat cafe. Let's head in and check it out. Wow. Look at this place. Kitty. Kitty, kitty.
Hello.
Oh, hi. Rachel West with Dtown.
I'm Sanaa. Welcome.
Sanaa, I have to tell you, this is a really cool place you have here.
Thank you. Is this your first time?
It is.
Well, we have 11 cats. They're up for adoption as well. So you can look around when you're, you know, when you're ready. You can also order some coffee, tea, hot chocolate, or snacks if you want anything.
I think I will take you up on that. I'll take one hot tea.
Awesome.
And this delicious chocolate chip cookie.
Sounds wonderful.
Mmm.
Is that ready for you?
And is it okay if I take a look around and just meet up with my feline friends-to-be?
Absolutely. Like I said, there's 11 of them, so look around and let me know what you think.
I will. Thank you very much. I'll catch up with you in just a little bit.
Sounds good, Rachel.
Let's go take a look. Look at this cutie pie. Aren't you cute? So comfortable looking. What if I slept all day in a bed by the window, curled up in the sun? I don't think that would go over very well. But somehow you pull it off pretty darn good.
Don't walk away from me. I'm like, I don't want to play with that right now.
Oh yeah, take a look at this. 3D cat cards. I'm gonna get those later on. Oh, take a look. Uh-huh. Please. Perfect. What do you think? I think so too. Nice. Ooh. Well, hello there. Looks like it's bath time. Can I say hi? Can I say hi? The focus. Like, there. This is immense focus. Yes. Hi. Oh, thank you. That's what I was looking for right there. Guess you have some work to do there. I'm gonna be here for a while. I'll see you in a couple minutes.
This is really cool. Hey, Rachel. So, did you have any questions?
Oh, Sana, I have to tell you, after meeting all my feline friends, I'm pretty impressed. Tell me exactly what we have going on here.
So, it's a cat cafe, which is a newer concept to the US, but it's been around for at least a decade now abroad. The whole idea is that there's cats that are rescues and they live on site and they're up for adoption. But meanwhile, while they're waiting to be adopted, they're available for people to hang out with and play with, people who can't have cats at home, or people who just love cats so much that they can't get enough of them. So it's just a fun place for people, for kids, cats, for everybody. And then it has the happy side effect of finding homes for cats.
So great that you've decided to do this in Dtown, because now we have like a flagship cat cafe.
That's exactly right. I know, we're on the map.
Yes, that's really cool. Dtown is a cat loving city. What's your favorite part about this experience, having this in Dtown?
Well, obviously the cats, bringing a community of people together who otherwise are somewhat invisible. Cat owners are more indoor people, and you know, dog owners are more visible outside. So it's kind of nice to see a community of people coming outside that don't usually get to relate with other cat owners.
Plus, we all get to pet the kitties. We can't leave out the artwork. There's tons of artwork involved here, paintings. Mm-hmm. Tell me about how this all fits together.
We partnered up with Taylor Street Gallery, which is another local small business, to do painting classes, which are $30 a pop, and you can come to one of the pre-scheduled classes, get instruction, get the materials, and you paint one of the cat paintings that you see around you. You can also do the open studio, which is what you see here, paint a cat for $15. You don't paint an actual cat, you just do a cat painting. They give you the supplies, they give you the canvas. And
no cats were actually painted during the process.
No, although they do dip their tails in the palette sometimes, so that happens.
Right. Well, hey, you know, they want to have some artistic
expression. Totally.
Well, I think I might be getting my artistic juices flowing. What about setting me up with some paint?
Absolutely, we can do that.
You heard her. It's time for some painting. Let's make this happen. All right, it's time for Dtown's Denver Cat Company masterpiece. Let's paint a cat. Now for the finishing touches. Art, cats, cafe. Perfect. Check out my masterpiece.
Thanks to Sana and all the new feline and human friends we met at the Denver Cat Company. Much more fun to come when we return. SAME. It stands for So All May Eat, but this cafe is anything but the same. The mission here? Serving good food for the greater good. Yes, here at SAME Cafe on East Colfax, it's about building a healthy community by providing the basic need of food in a respectful and dignified manner to anyone who walks through the door. Nice.
I come here almost every day, it seems like. So I see people of all makes and kinds. People that, you know, are well off and have a family, to people who don't, you know, who are off the street.
SAME is the first nonprofit restaurant in Denver. Here, the patrons set the price. Those who can pay a little more can donate some extra money for their meal. Those who have a little less pay what they can. And if your pockets are empty, you can volunteer at the cafe in exchange for your meal.
Even if I don't have $2 or more, it is good because these folks will let me do a half hour's worth of work for the nice meal. So even if I'm broke, I can't lose. I can come up here and help, and I still get a good meal, for real.
I have Western windows, I have warranty plates.
The menu here is not set. The cafe features daily selections of fresh, organic foods. A healthy, delicious experience for all.
I like to give back. I come and I donate a lot here, and so I think it's really a cool way to, you know, connect with the community. It's a very community-oriented restaurant, and that's why I come here to eat, and the food is good.
Same cafe, wonderfully different. Quiz time. This year, Same Cafe is celebrating which anniversary? Their second, fifth, or 10th? This year, Same Cafe is celebrating their 10th anniversary. Congratulations, Same! Thanksgiving. It should be a time for all to celebrate and enjoy a good meal. And thanks to the amazing folks at the Squeaky Bean, it is. Yep, come to this restaurant prepared to explore your inner bean. There are some fun elements here, including a spoon chandelier. And what self-respecting restaurant doesn't have a disco ball? There are also cool events like Bean Bingo Brunch on Saturdays. In 2012, the Squeaky Bean moved from the Highlands to the historic Saddlery building in Lower Downtown. Now this restaurant has a proper kitchen and a stunning bar and dining room, and there's plenty of room for a playful inventiveness in each dish. The Bean boasts an ever-changing menu of seasonal culinary intrigue, so that each trip is a new experience. And last year, the Squeaky Bean filled a void in our community, taking the place of Rosalinda's in feeding the hungry on Thanksgiving. They provided free meals of turkey and trimmings, including, of course, green bean casserole. They served over 3,000 people. Nice job. Hey, sounds like a good excuse to visit the Squeaky Bean to help folks on Thanksgiving. Quiz time. The Squeaky Bean uses locally sourced organic foods from a plot of land called Bean Acre, Squeaky Garden, or Beans Greens. The answer, most of the vegetation is grown at Bean Acre.
Now here's a very special way to share the love through food. Do you know of the Women's Bean Project? Maybe you've heard of it, or maybe you don't know beans about it. Either way, we've scored a behind-the-scenes tour for you. Let's check it out.
We took a quick sneak peek at this amazing job training program for chronically unemployed and impoverished women. Then we caught up with Tamara, the CEO of Women's Bean Project.
We are a manufacturing operation that happens to have a mission to change women's lives. So we hire a woman for a 9-month job, and during the time that she's with us, we help her make the changes in her life that will lead to long-term employment, increased self-esteem, stabilizing her life, and that all happens in 9 months, and then we help her transition out into the community to a full-time job.
It's a big mission you've taken on, more than might appear on the surface.
Well, a lot happens because a woman who comes to us typically hasn't had a job longer than a year in her lifetime, though the average age is 36. So it's a lot of years of not having success, of really fighting to gain stability. And so when she comes here, she gets the first glimpse of what her future could look like. And I think that in and of itself is transformational. But we're really looking at all the skills that she needs to be a better employee, as well as a better mom. Just about every woman who comes here is a mom. And so when you think about not just her change, the changes she makes, but the changes her children make as well. I mean, I firmly believe that if you change a mother's life, you change her family's life.
There's no doubt about the progress that's been made. And you get some really awesome food at the end,
right,
too.
Well, that's the great thing, is that, you know, there's tangible evidence of a woman whose life is being changed. Every one of our products is signed by a program participant. It says lovingly handmade by in the name of a woman who's in our program. We get letters from people all the time that says, "Dear Amelia, I just had your soup and it was so delicious. Please keep up the good work."
Oh my goodness. I mean, you can't put a price on that.
No, you can't. What I often say is that when a woman graduates our program, she believes she's worthy of a better life. And I don't know how you measure that, but you sure know it when you see it.
Thank you, Tamara.
Thank
we appreciate
you.
It. I have some soups to check out now.
So I dove right in and started packing some soup.
All right, here we are where the magic happens for the Women's Bean Project. I'm here with Becky. I'm ready to learn some bean packing. How does it happen?
Well, first, you gotta put in the beans in the bag.
Okay, and you're using this cool little funnel thing so you can get it in there easier.
Yeah, otherwise it goes all over the place.
You don't want a bean mess.
No.
So how do you know? Is it three scoops and then
it's
you're
about,
done?
It's about 2.5.
Okay.
And then I pack it a little bit, and then I take it to my scale, which says 0.2. So 13.2.
Yay!
Yes.
All right.
So, and then you just put it here, and then it'll go on to the next step.
Okay.
So
okay.
Now your turn.
Becky says it's my turn. Okay.
Okay, so here you go.
Okay, take the bag.
Get the funnel.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Funnel inside the bag. You made it look so easy. So we want the first one to be one full one,
yeah.
Right? Okay. In go the beans. Nice. Okay, now one more full one.
Yes. I can do anything. I can reach any goal today. I can do what I want. I can be what
12.4.
I want.
I'm off by a lot, Becky. You're being nice to me. Here we have the correct amount.
She got it.
All right, what happens next?
And then next, it goes to here where Lorraine can explain to you.
All right, Becky, well, thank you for the bagging lesson. I feel like I'm an expert now.
Okay.
Do you think I am?
Yes.
I have Becky's seal of approval. Lorraine, nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
All right, so what happens next? We bag the beans. What do we have to do to get them ready?
Then we pick up the bag.
Okay.
Okay. I start from the bottom.
So we're kind of trying to mush them all together.
Yeah.
We want them in here really,
really
tight.
I can be what I want to be.
After some bean smacking 101, we put the spice packets in.
Now these are the spice mixes that you guys also prepare here too, right?
Yes.
Okay. You can really get your frustrations out when you come to work, huh?
Right, right. Smack it one more time. And then we're going to twist it.
All right, so now it's done. I mean, we're pretty much getting it ready. Here we go. Wow, that's a handy dandy machine you've got there.
Very easy.
That is awesome. Now what happens after we get it all taped up and they're ready to go?
And then I give them to Kelly.
I see your name on the name tag, Kelly. What's this all about? We have some really cool name tags here.
Yeah, this is a great way for us to show that these were lovingly handmade by us and all the participants in the program. And then we get to tie our names on each of the packets. They get shipped all over the world, which is amazing that everybody knows, you know, that we did all the hard work to make this possible.
And that's how we make the mix.
Make the beans.
That's how we make the beans. Thank you, everybody. This was a good time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Then it was time to pack some cornbread mix. Yum.
And Alicia, you're gonna show me how to do the baking area.
Yes.
All right, what do we do? I guess since I'm suited up, I have to do some work today,
yes,
huh?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so let's scoop the cornmeal. Here we go.
Yes.
Okay, so first scoop.
Okay, and then get another scoop.
It turns out Alicia, cornbread measurer extraordinaire, is a veteran of the program.
I was in New Mexico and I moved over here to start a new life, a new beginning, because I recently got a divorce in 2009 and I was married for 25 years and I lost everything, my business, my home, my car, and my animals, my pets. So I moved over here to start a new life. And when I moved over here, I was working through temp agencies. I couldn't find a full-time job. So I came over here and I applied. And they hired me as a participant. And I've been here since then. When I walked through those doors, I was scared, of course. But then once I got into it, the classes that they provide for us, and the production line, you know, I got good at it.
Wow. I'm going to call you the master because I have a little inside information. You've graduated.
Yes, I did.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yes, I graduated and they hired me full-time to be a team leader to show the other ladies what I've learned.
That's awesome.
Yes.
So you've graduated. Now you're working here full-time.
Yes.
What does this mean to you on a daily basis now that you get to come in and help out the other women?
It makes me feel good just to be that team leader and to show them that it is possible. You know, you can change if you really want to. It's up to you.
Awesome job, Alicia. Then it was time to sit down with Katie, a current employee in the program. After a rough time in her life, she's now a single mother and trying to make a better life for her and her son.
So how bad did things get in your situation?
I was pretty hopeless. You know, I was given no respect in my relationship, and my opinion was completely discarded. And I felt like I deserved that because I hadn't brought anything of value to the relationship. And that's a really dark place to think of yourself. I remember the first day I came in those doors, I was very nervous and scared of what the other women were gonna think of me and how they would treat me. And every day that I've come back in, I have learned, and they have helped me open my eyes to the fact that I am strong and I'm capable, and that the only limitation in this world is my state of mind. So that was the biggest effect, is I've gone from somebody who believed I couldn't do anything to somebody who knows I'm capable of doing anything.
So really, it's almost like the Women's Bean Project allowed you to see you for who you are and who you can be.
Yeah, their approach is amazing. The staff here is just so great at being encouraging and soft-worded and very kind. By no means have they stopped any hardships, but they have helped me learn skills to overcome them. One of my biggest struggles that the Women's Bean Project has been helping me with is housing for myself and my son. But getting that not accepted letter doesn't destroy me the way it used to. And I've got the courage to submit one more, make one more phone call, try again, and to do it proud and happy.
Well, Katie, you mentioned that you're proud of yourself. I have to say that Dtown is proud of you.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
Thank you for sitting down with us. Wow, the Women's Bean Project is totally awesome and so important. But we can't come to a food production facility and not get a sample, can we? Oh no, we've got chocolate-covered espresso beans. Let's give one a try. I'm gonna get one. Here we go. Mmm, oh yeah. These are delicious. Mmm. I'll be back.
And here's some great news. You too can take a tour of the Women's Bean Project and even get a free lunch to sample their products. Yay! It happens the first Friday of every month. You just need to RSVP at womensbeanproject.com. Thanks to all our amazing new friends at Women's Bean Project.
Next time you need a gift, including for yourself, check out these amazing products. Cool beans! See you on the other side for more food from the heart. This is delicious.
Vesta Dipping Grill and The Squeaky Bean are just two of the more than 250 restaurants that take part in a fabulous event each year. It's called Dining Out for Life, and it benefits Project Angel Heart. The mission at Project Angel Heart is to prepare nutritious meals in their own kitchen and then deliver them to Coloradans with life-threatening illnesses. Here's how Dining Out for Life works. Every year in April, one night is set aside at the participating restaurants for the event. 25% of the proceeds on that day go to support Project Angel Heart. Very cool. Oh, and 200 volunteer ambassadors are needed to make the Dining Out for Life event successful. So, if you're interested, I'm sure they'd love to hear from you. Last year, an estimated $300,000 was raised to support the Home Delivered Meal Program. So, you can help support the restaurants that support Project Angel Heart. Okay, which of these events is also a benefit for Project Angel Heart? Food for Life, Pie in the Sky, or Dining for Dollars? The answer is Pie in the Sky. Sounds like fun.
So, are you hungry yet? Here's the recap.
Food is a great way to share the love. And there are some awesome Denver cafes, restaurants, and projects that have a very big heart. Same cafe means so all may eat. Here, anyone who walks in the door will be fed. Patrons who can afford to pay more for their meals can donate a little extra. And those whose pockets are empty can volunteer their time in exchange for their meal. Nice. Also nice, the food. Fresh, organic daily selections. The Squeaky Bean is an awesome restaurant with organic vegetables grown locally. Plus, Bean Bingo Brunch. But at Thanksgiving, the Squeaky Bean really steps up and provides 3,000 meals for the hungry. Women's Bean Project helps change women's lives by providing stepping stones to self-sufficiency. A job training program for chronically unemployed and impoverished women. They package many tasty treats sold all over the world. Vesta Dipping Grill hosts an annual event called Plates for the Peak to benefit homeless youth and those at risk for homelessness through Urban Peak. It's great food for a great cause. Love to eat out? How about dining out for life? One day a year, over 250 restaurants donate 25% of their profits to Project Angel Heart. This wonderful nonprofit organization prepares and delivers meals to those with life-threatening illnesses. Denver Urban Gardens provides seeds and plantings to low-income residents so they may grow their own fresh, healthy food through private, school, and community gardens. And don't forget about our four-legged friends. Denver Cat Company provides more than a beverage and snack. Here you can visit with adoptable cats and maybe take one home. More than 100 cats have been adopted in the cafe's first year of operation. Perfect. So, how do you share the love with food and what awesome foods do you love? Let us know on Facebook. Hey little guy, do you want some? Cats don't eat cookies, humans eat cookies. Mmm. Well, it's true, we let the cat out of the bag. We've spilled the beans. We've let you in on some great foods for a cause. Happy eating. See you next time for more awesome Dtown adventures. I'm eating all of this. So good. Mmm, yeah.